Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Alzar Aurelio. Good morning, Alzar.
Hello and good morning. Tropical Storm Helen was spotted at 1,150 kilometers east-northeast of extreme northern Luzon. Tropical storm has a maximum sustained winds of 85 kilometers per hour. It is expected to move generally westward, traversing the right corner of Philippine area of responsibility. Because of this forecast track, it is not expected to make landfall to any part of the country. Meanwhile, the tropical depression here is already outside the Philippine area of responsibility, and for the next 24 hours, it is not expected to affect the weather today. For today's forecast, southwest monsoon enhanced by both tropical cyclone affects the most part of the country. So expected to have moderate or heavy to intense rains over Mimaropa, Western Visayas, Batangas, Sambales, Bataan, and Pangasinan. We saw this scenario, possible flash flood and landslide due to the pouring rains. Meanwhile, Metro Manila, Zamboanga Peninsula, Barm, Caraga, Northern Mindanao, Cordillera, Bicol Region, and the rest of Visayas, Calabarzon, Central Luzon, and Ilocos Region will have a cloudy sky with scattered rains and thunderstorm. The rest of the country will have generally fair weather, which is partly cloudy to cloudy sky with isolated rains due to thunderstorm. Tropical Storm Helen expected to exit PAR today. And after that, expected to move toward the southern part of China. Because of the southwest monsoon, we have a gale warning and expected to have a wave height up to almost 5 meters. The areas affected follows western seaboard of Central Luzon up to Visayas. That's our weather update from Pagasa. I am Alzar D. Aurelio.
Thank you very much for that update, Alzar. A former police chief allegedly received bribe to help dismissed Bambantarlac Mayor Alice Go flee the country. Victoria Tulad reports.
A former chief of the Philippine National Police is allegedly involved in the escape of dismissed Bambantarlac Mayor Alice Go. This was revealed during the Senate inquiry in illegal pogos on Tuesday by retired General Raul Villanueva, citing unverified reports from the intelligence community. Villanueva is the senior vice president of the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, or PAGCOR.
Alin pong PNP units ang binabanggit sa usap-usapan?
I don't know, ma'am, but former chief PNP daw. Parang usapan dun, ma'am, parang nasa payroll, yung monthly payroll. Ever seen.
Senator Ronald De La Rosa asked Go to name the said former PNP chief.
I am concerned because I am a former chief PNP. Baka mamaya mayroong lalabas na script dyan na si Bato ay tumatanggap ng pera galing sa'yo.
Wala pong ganun pong nangyayari.
Meanwhile, Suwal Pangasinan Mayor Liseldo Calugay faced the Senate for the first time. Senators grilled Calugay on his relationship with Go, given that they attended each other's campaign caravans. A photo was also shown where both seemed to be wearing couple shirts. Calugay admitted to sending Go a huge bouquet on Valentine's Day. He said he met Go in 2016 when he was looking for a pig supplier.
Actually, wala po akong pakialam kung meron man kayong romantic relationship. Wala po akong pakialam doon. We are interested in the possibility of your criminal relationship.
Calugay maintained that he does not have a business nor a joint bank account with Go. He also denied allegations that Go left through Happy Penguin Resort, which sits on a land he previously owned. According to Kalugay's executive assistant, Cheryl Medina, she helped GOS staff look for a notary public. This was confirmed by GOS Secretary Catherine Salazar. Salazar is suspected of being GOS doppelganger to confuse authorities looking for the mayor since she resembles her.
Your Honor, yun po yung instruction po ni ma'am. Tinawagan niya po ako. Tawagan ko daw po si Ma'am Che kung may kilala daw po na lawyer na magnonotaryo po.
A certain Ka Dante was referred by Medina to Salazar. He was the one who supposedly approached Attorney Elmer Galicia, the notary public who notarized Goss counter affidavit. In Ka Dante's sworn affidavit, he said Kalugay's personal secretary, Cherry Ordonia, called him to ask if he knew a notary public. He confirmed that Goss' other secretary, G. Pepito, brought him the document but said it was unsigned. G supposedly went to a vehicle across the street, after which a passenger who looked like Alice Go rolled down her window and waved. G then gave Ka Dante the signed document. Salazar said, however, that Go did not see Ka Dante and they didn't know where she was. She insisted that the document was also already signed.
Tumawag po siya, Your Honor. Ang sabi po niya, punta daw po ako sa bahay niya, may kukunin po isang brown envelope. Tapos nung nakuha ko na po at Your Honor, tinanong ko po siya kung ano pong gagawin ko. Ang sabi po niya, i-attach ko daw po sa last page nung affidavit po niya.
Sinayin ko po yung last page po bago po ako umalis.
Go fled on the first week of July.
Hindi ito pinirmahan sa harap ni Attorney Galicia. Definitely, nagsinungaling siya at dapat siyang kasuhan rin ng DOJ. Number two, itong ganitong document, abogado nagpre-prepare nito eh. At prepare ito first week of July, yung alleged escape ni Go Huaping. So ang ibig sabihin, ng mga abogado niya, alam rin na aalis siya. Kasi pinirmahan niya in advance eh.
Your Honor, we really have no knowledge, Your Honor. Ms. Kat messaged us requesting if we can forward the draft counter affidavit to her so she can print and have it signed by Mayor Guo, Your Honor.
Biktima po ako. I am invoking my right against self-incrimination po.
According to Guo, she is not close to Duan Wenwu, the executive of Whirlwind Corporation, which leased a property to the Pogo Lucky South 99 in Porac, Pampanga. She only knows him through Catherine Cassandra Ong, the girlfriend of her brother, Wesley. Meanwhile, Senate President Pro Tempore Jinggoy Estrada wants the Philippine Statistics Authority to investigate the issuance of a birth certificate to Ong, who is the authorized representative of Lucky South 99.
Allegedly, the mother of Cassie Ong, wala negative record of birth in the PSACRS database. Negative din ang record sa based on record of marriage in the PSACRS database.
The PSA has already launched a fact-finding investigation on the matter. Victoria Tulad, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatchalian calls for a probe on the possible involvement of banks with illegal offshore gaming firms. Gatchalian filed a resolution for a Senate inquiry into how banks supposedly failed to flag suspicious transactions related to the construction of Pogo hubs. He says this raises questions about the effectiveness of internal bank controls. Gatchalian presented a graph during a Senate hearing on Pogos, how huge deposits were made to the personal bank accounts of dismissed Mayor Alice Go. He noted how a total of 1.9 billion pesos were deposited from 2018 to 2024, or around the time a Pogo hub was built in Go's hometown of Bambantarlac. Gatchalian asked Go where the money came from, but Go refused to answer.
This is an obvious case of money laundering dahil yung pera hindi natin pumapasok dito na hindi natin alam saan nanggagaling. Dapat tinideclare to sa gobyerno. Sinasabi to sa atin ng banko, sinasabi mo rin sa banko kung saan galing tong perang to. Pero until now, walang alam kung saan nanggagaling itong perang ito.
The tit-for-tat tirades between members of the House Quad Committee and former Duterte spokesman Harry Roque continues. House lawmakers are urging Roque to man up and face them as he tries to evade arrest. Roque is accusing lawmakers of power tripping for citing him in contempt again. But QuadCom leaders say Roque's refusal to cooperate only makes him look guilty.
Hindi mo siya pwedeng questionin na nagpa-power trip yung mga members eh. You have to remember that it is included in the rules of the House of Representatives. And nakikita mo naman that they are really violating by evading our questions and lying in front of all of us. If we really wanted to pursuing other things in order to avoid it, then there will always be a presumption of guilt.
Eh, saan ho nang galing yung pagtaas ng yaman ng Biancham Corporation mula ng 125,000 ang 2016 na naging 150 million in 2018. Yung Biancham Corporation ay siya ang nagmamayari at may kaugnayan dito sa Lucky South 99. There are overwhelming circumstantial evidence.
The Philippine National Police and other law enforcement agencies have intensified their manhunt for Roque with the deployment of special tracker teams. The PNP ensures due process in the search.
Yung BID, meron namang lookout bulletin sa kanya. We would know kung umalis siya o paalis siya o aalis o nakaalis siya. No? So far, wala namang info sa amin.
All effort po ng ginagawa po ng all law enforcement, not only the Philippine National Police, but all law enforcement po ang natumutulong po sa pag-anap po. Hindi naman po kami ihinto.
The QuadCom is scheduled to resume its inquiry Thursday. The Philippine military is looking into allegations Army reservists are working for disgraced televangelist Apollo Quiboloy in a private army called Angels of Death. Army Colonel Reynaldo Balido Jr. says the head of Quiboloy's media network, SMNI, will be questioned by authorities on its possible links to the private army. Balido says the network is affiliated with the army as a reserve battalion. The alleged sexual abuse victims of Quiboloy claim the pastor warned them of harm from the Angels of Death if they told anyone about their experiences.
Kung mapatunayan ito sila, dahil sila nga ay duty bound pa rin, no? Meron silang dapat i-uphold na professionalism, duty, honor.
Kahit reservist.
Yes po. May mga corresponding disciplinary measures na mabibigay sa mga mapatunayan na nagkasala or may ginawang hindi akma doon sa kanilang sinumpaang tumulong.